This video provides an overview of the Homeless Management Information System, also known as HMIS. You will learn about the purpose and benefits of HMIS, the types of data in the system, how you can use the HMIS software, and how HMIS contributes to LASA's mission to reduce homelessness. HMIS is a tool used to track and coordinate resources that support people experiencing homelessness. As part of the largest continuum of care in the country, HMIS plays a key role in allowing service providers, public agencies, volunteers, and other stakeholders to better identify and meet the needs of people experiencing or at risk of experiencing homelessness in Los Angeles County. HMIS is a regional approach led by LASA to collect more reliable data on homelessness as required by the Department of Housing and Urban Development. The implementation of HMIS provides funders with an effective monitoring mechanism to assess the performance of agencies they fund. This, in effect, allows funders to clearly communicate their performance targets to service providers, which leads to a greater level of accountability. In addition, HMIS offers other benefits for service providers. The system enables agencies to record accurate information about the participants they serve. HMIS promotes efficiency in terms of completing funding reports. The system encourages agencies to improve the quality of services provided. And it enables service providers to analyze and adapt to the needs of people experiencing homelessness. Furthermore, HMIS improves the coordination of services and care for participants, reduces the duplication of information, and safeguards participants' confidentiality. Finally, HMIS benefits the community in the following ways. The system informs government officials and the public about the state of homelessness over time in Los Angeles County. And the system provides information about housing and support needs to potential funders and policymakers. Now, let's explore the types of data found in HMIS. The three main types of data in HMIS include participant demographic data, program and service utilization data, and information about agencies and their programs. The participant demographic data include name, date of birth, ethnicity, and race. The program and service utilization data provide information about the participant, services provided, and participant outcomes. Some of these elements include source of income, bed services, and referrals. Another type of data in HMIS is information about agencies and their programs. This identifies elements such as organization name, program address, federal partner funding sources, and other project information. Now that we understand the types of data collected in HMIS, let's explore the interface of our HMIS software, Clarity. After logging into Clarity, you will be directed to the homepage. From here, you can search for an existing participant, check your caseload, or begin adding a new participant. In the upper right corner, you will notice the waffle-shaped icon, which is called the launcher. The launcher provides access to the report function, calendar, and attendance. The report function also allows you to pull reports such as your program roster report. In addition to the launcher, Clarity has a messaging tool. You can use this feature to communicate with other HMIS users within or outside your agency. Next, after searching for and identifying a participant in HMIS, you will see a series of tabs appear under the participant's account, and each tab will contain the available information about the participant. The tabs help HMIS users navigate the system so they can record any essential information in the appropriate data field. One of these tabs is the Profile tab, which contains many of the participant demographic data identified earlier. For instance, the name, date of birth, and so on. Next, we have the History tab, which contains color-coded information previously recorded on behalf of the participant. This includes program enrollment information, which are color-coded yellow, completed assessments, which are color-coded green, system referrals, which are color-coded blue. Then, provided services information are color-coded white, and emergency shelter bed reservations are color-coded reddish-pink. In case you get lost, just follow the legend at the bottom of the history page. The assessment tab contains the triage tools used to assess HMIS participants. These triage tools include the CES for Individuals, the CES Survey Part 1, the CES for Youth, also known as the Next Step tool, CES for Families, the VIF SPDAT, and the Homelessness Prevention Targeting tools. Clicking on the Services tab will provide a list of loose services available to a participant. These loose services are not tied to a specific program. Next, the Notes tab contains two sections, which include the Notes section and the Public Alert section. In the Notes section, service providers record general, non-medical information about the participant. Users can also add a public alert section to record instances of violence, hostility, or aggression involving the participant and other participants or staff members. In the Files tab, HMIS users upload and record documents for program eligibility and information verification purposes. In the Location tab, users record physical addresses relevant to the participant, such as their work address, school address, mailing address, address of emergency contact, and so on. Finally, the Programs tab displays the Program History and Programs Available sections. The Program History section contains past and present program enrollments, while the Program Available section contains a list of programs affiliated with the user's agency. In the last section of this overview, let's review how HMIS ties into LASA's mission to end and prevent homelessness in Los Angeles County. HMIS contributes to reducing homelessness in the following ways. First, planners and policymakers use HMIS data to better inform homeless policy and decision-making at the federal, state, and local levels. Second, it allows service providers to analyze data from programs to determine funding priorities. Third, HMIS measures program effectiveness by providing information on how well programs connect people to housing. Finally, HMIS provides better data quality, which paves the way for better services and program management. We are all done, but first, let's do a brief review. In this video, we've discussed HMIS basic definition, the benefits of HMIS, the types of data in HMIS, how users interact with the HMIS software, Clarity, and the role HMIS plays in reducing homelessness.